Los Angeles is a beautiful city. Hopefully my video is evidence of that fact.
El coche favorito.
You're at 109 right now.
But you don't hear me though.
Today I went to Olvera Street. At one time, Olvera Street, the plaza, that was the center of the city of Los Angeles. The city was much smaller back then, but that was the center. So I spent my day there. My adventure today begins at Union Station. The beautiful Union Station. What am I going to do today? I've got no idea. What brings me to Union Station? I was driving around not far from here and I needed to use the restroom. And I said, hey, I bet they have clean restrooms there. No, they do not. No. They do not have clean restrooms here. None. No. Don't make that mistake. Hanguk saram diri. So much for not knowing what I'm gonna do today. I think I found exactly what I'm gonna do. Hola mi gente, hoy es un buen día para disfrutar coches. La cultura de Los Ángeles incluye coches buenas, extremadamente. Voy a ver a las coches en Olvera calle de Olvera. Vámonos. Now, what you're about to see is my day. It's a recap of the things that I saw today in and around Olvera Street. All right, I hope you enjoy this video. Also, I really want to stress the fact that I began studying Spanish when I was in elementary school. And I didn't have access to the language because of identity politics. This is something that I feel strongly about. If we don't think that we are, I mean, that's kind of deep. If you don't see yourself as, if you see yourself different from those people, if you have a us versus them mentality, well, that's going to hurt you. All right. And I think in my case, throughout my life, because I saw Latinos but Spanish speakers, I saw them as not like me. They have their own culture. They have their own style, cuisine, religion, and of course, language. And I saw that as, wow, that's so different from me. Well, that's for them. That's not for me. But when I traveled the globe, when I traveled the world, my education, I had to rely upon my education, and I realized, hey, I know the language better than I think, or rather better than I thought that I did. I learned the language. I learned the basics, the numbers and nouns and small phrases. But those were building blocks that allowed me to communicate my needs and my wants when I traveled to Spanish-speaking countries. And so, but I never gave myself as much credit for speaking the language because of my grade, the grades that I received, like B's and C's in those classes. And for me, it was difficult because I couldn't practice the language at home. And so, learning a foreign language, learning another language is difficult, primarily because of proximity. If it's not there immediately for you to practice the language, well, it's going to be difficult for you to acquire that language, that knowledge as a skill. But anyway, when I traveled to Peru for the first time, I was, oh my gosh, I couldn't believe it. I was like, I know what things are, you know? You remember el baño? I mean, because I usually have to use the restroom, you know? That's very important no matter what. I'm not making a joke. I mean, it's kind of funny, but it's serious too. You always need to know where the restrooms are. Then, teléfono, you know? Comida, gente, corazón, you know, all of these things came to the front of my mind because in America I was speaking English and that was in the back of my mind. I was like, when am I ever going to use that? And then when I went to Peru, then it was like, use it now, fool. And then when I went to Cuba, well, Cuba is different, you know, because I couldn't understand the Cubans, even though they were speaking Spanish. That's something that I discovered. Like, although it's the Spanish language, there are linguistics, there are patterns of, you know, through people's instinctive travels throughout the world, you know, things change, right? Spanish is not Spanish wherever you go. It is, but it isn't. It's a whole thing. Listen. In this video, when I try to speak Spanish, I'm literally trying to speak Spanish. I know, it's bad. My Spanish is bad. Pero necesito practicar mi español. ¿Cómo? ¿Cómo mejorar? ¿Mejora? ¿Cómo sería mejor mi español si no practico? I'm trying to say, how can I improve my Spanish if I don't practice? This is more discussion than I thought it would be. Look, I meant no disrespect, okay? I meant to anyone, a Spanish speaker, to anyone, Chicano, Mexicano, America, Mexicano, Mexican-American, Guatemalan, you know, El Salvadorian, Cuban, Puerto Rican. Okay, I meant no disrespect. What I'm trying to do here is just live freely. And so this is what you're going to see in this video. You're going to see me going to a lowrider show, a lowrider event in Los Angeles. And I'm doing it as just an Angelino, right? I didn't know anything about this event. It was happening. I saw it in front of me and I said, yo, I'm going to go check it out. I'm going to make a video about it. I'm going to enjoy my day. So I hope you enjoy this video as you watch it. Lastly, at the end of the video, I tried to get into some of the more controversial topics about Los Angeles' history. So if you watch the video all the way to the end, thank you. Please like the video. Subscribe, you know, all that YouTube stuff, but stay to the end to hear a little bit about the real history about Los Angeles. Again, I mean, no disrespect. Hopefully these videos will pique your curiosity about the things that I'm talking about. I am not a professor on these topics, but I'm certainly here to hopefully entertain, but also pique your curiosity about you know, historic events. I'm Larry Wiggs, and you're watching IC 10-9. Peace and blessings to everyone. I'm out. Isn't that pretty right there? So pretty, so fly. Look at this. So can I find a car with license plate 109 on it? Can I? Let's see if I find a 109 somewhere. Celebración de la cultura de coches en Los Ángeles. Viva la raza, viva mexicanos. Mexicanos, México tiene, o tuve, México tuve un presidente mujer. Antes de los Estados Unidos. Ojalá que en el futuro, muy pronto, los Estados Unidos va a tener un presidente mujer también, muy pronto, ojalá. I don't see 109. Where's 109 on a car? Chicos, 62. Taco House. Peachy folders in the back, little cholas. Oh my gosh. Oh, and they have a sunroof too, a moonroof. 79, grumpy. Coches.
año. ¿Hay un problema con esta coche?
No sé.
Ay, ay, ay. Qué extraño.
This is Los Angeles. Headed back to Union Station now. This is Los Angeles. Voy a la estación de Unión, de Unidad, ahora.
Este evento en Los Ángeles es muy increíble, increíble para la cultura de coches en Los Ángeles. Ahora estoy en Calle de los Negros. Este es el lugar de Calle de los Negros. Es un histórico calle con una historia increíble y voy a hablar un poco sobre la historia de Calle de los Negros. Acá es el lugar de Calle de los Negros. Right here is Calle de los Negros. This is that alley with an incredible story, incredible history. I'm glad I'm able to walk over here. But this is wild. This is extremely wild. All right, so what you're looking at right here is basically, what you're looking at is ground zero. This is Calle de los Negros.
This is that alley. This is that area in the 1800s that was called Black Street. All of this. Where this freeway is right here, where it begins here, this parking lot, all of this area here was Black Street. And look, we have a beautiful occasion, beautiful day today with the low lows and a celebration of La Raza, Los Latinos, all right? Chicanos, Mexicanos, todos la gente de Latinoamérica y Norte America, right? The Mexicans are North Americans too, right? All right, so get a look at this. This is Los Angeles Street. It's today known as Los Angeles Street. We're at the corner. But Los Angeles Street is Black Street. This is where Los Angeles Street begins in the city of Los Angeles. This is fascinating, fascinating history to stand right here at this location. You have right behind me, that building right there, that was a Chinese establishment, a business, Chinese businesses were there. This was like China, well, we're not far from Chinatown, but there's today that's a Chinese museum. And the museum was created or constructed around a Chinese business that's been there for probably hundreds of years, right? And then right there at the corner, this building right here, that's like the first fire department. The first fire department in Los Angeles, right there. And then this street right here on the other side of this street where this parking lot is, there were businesses all up and down here. And this was a short one block distance, and it was known as Calle de los Negros. And then the white boys called it something very terrible. They wanted to denigrate and diminish their African counterparts. Horrible history, but this is a huge part of Los Angeles. This location right here, this is a confluence of culture. This is Olvera Street. This is, you know, African Black history in Los Angeles. Because here's the thing, guys. Along this street, Black businessmen, Black businesses existed. It wasn't the best of times. Apparently, right here in this area, 30 people would die every month. One person per day would be killed in this area. This is a deadly area, historically. But viva la raza. Los Latinos are here and they make it beautiful, baby. Beautiful. Look at how beautiful Los Angeles Street is right now. But man, what a history. Know your history. That's the importance of this video right here. Know your history, yo. ¿Cómo se dice bittersweet? ¿Cómo se dice bittersweet? Esta es bittersweet. La historia, las coches hermosas y total. This has to be my favorite right here. I mean, I guess so, but I wonder, like, what's wrong with this one, man? What's up with this car? Something's wrong with it? Man, how'd they do that to that car? I don't know, man. All right, so in addition to getting a view of these beautiful cars, got a bit of a lesson, too. A lesson on history. So this is where Los Angeles Street begins. Los Angeles Street begins right here.
And right up that way, back that way, all right, that was Calle de los Negros. History, y'all.
Even though I did not see 109 on any of the lowriders, I did see 109 today. It was a sign that today would be a good day. It certainly was. Peace and blessings.